Good morning, Cougars. This is Mr. Martinez with the morning announcements.
Good morning, Mr. Martinez.
Okay, welcome everybody. So I think something is making a lot of noise. Is that? Do you know what that is, there, Bodhi?
No, I do not.
Okay, so we're getting a little feedback back, but Joy is under the weather, so it's going to be Bodhi and I leading this. Bodhi, I got a brand new flag. This comes to us from Una. This is Una in kindergarten. Check out her flag.
Wow, I like it. I like. All the stars are ready.
Yeah, nice work with her crayons. Thank you, Una. Bodhi, lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Okay. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. Big shout out to Una in kindergarten. I think you know what it is, Bodhi. Every time you're touching your computer, it must be near the microphone or something because we're getting feedback right there. Welcome, everybody. Today is Thursday. It is March 18th, the day after St. Patrick's Day. Got a beautiful day in Studio City, 69 degrees and sunny. It's going to be gorgeous. Bodhi, yesterday, fifth grade, your grade level had their annual spelling bee competition. Are you aware of the competition and who won?
I am.
Okay, well, we are so fortunate that we actually have the fifth grade champion joining us now. This is Hannah. Good morning, Hannah. Welcome.
Good morning, Mr. Martinez. Good morning, Bodhi.
Boys and girls, Hannah is the fifth grade spelling bee champion for this school year. Congratulations, Hannah.
Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. It was an intense competition yesterday. I was there. I viewed the whole thing, and it was amazing. Hannah, we've got a couple questions for you, and Bodhi's going to start off.
Okay. Hannah, tell us about how it feels to be the top speller in all of fifth grade.
It feels great. I'm really excited to win after all the other years I've been the spelling bee.
Okay. So, Hannah, tell us, when you competed in third and fourth grade, how did you do?
Last year in fourth grade, the two winners tied and I came second behind them.
Gosh, you were that close.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And then third grade?
Third grade, I think I got out in like the third round.
Okay. So boys and girls, if you're watching, just like Rebecca yesterday, you could see Hannah came in second place last year. She got to the third round in third grade, but she didn't give up. She kept trying. She had a good attitude. And look at her now. She's sitting in the first place for fifth grade as our spelling bee champ. That is awesome. That's perseverance right there. Bodhi, what else? What other question do you have for her?
What was the most difficult word you had to spell in the spelling bee and why?
It was constitution, because even though I know how to spell it, it's more difficult to spell longer words because I have to think about which letters I've already said and it just gets harder to say longer words.
Did you say the word was constitution?
Yes.
Oh, man. I would have been out in the first round, I'm pretty sure. Bodhi, how would you have done with the word constitution?
I think I would have narrowly got it.
Okay.
I'm just trying to be confident.
Hey, Hannah, listen, I don't know if you've won lots of things in your life or if this was one of the big ones, but when you won yesterday, did you do anything special last night or do you have any plans to celebrate this weekend?
We just got dinner from CPK last night.
Oh, okay, so like a victory CPK dinner, what'd you
eat? Yeah, I got mac and cheese.
Okay, mac and cheese. Everybody loves mac and cheese at CPK. So that's always great to celebrate with food. We're really proud of you, Hannah, and congratulations on being our fifth grade spelling bee champ.
Thank you.
All right. Hannah, do you know every Thursday we do something special on the morning announcements? Do you know what it is?
Bodhi's year-long song.
Exactly. Guess Bodhi's year-long song. So Bodhi and Hannah, we're gonna mute our microphones now, and Bodhi's gonna take over. Go ahead, Bodhi, it's all yours.
Thank you.
So okay, so Hannah, I that sounded very familiar to me. Did you did that sound familiar to you?
Yes.
Okay, so here's the thing. Do you know what that song, where that song's from?
Yes.
Where? Tell us. Where's it from?
Well, that's "Bad Guy" by Billie Eilish.
Yeah, it is.
Awesome! Oh my gosh, that was fantastic. Tell us all about that song, Bodhi.
Yeah, so the song is in fact "Bad Guy" by Billie Eilish, and the song is from Billie Eilish's album "When We Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go?" But Billie Eilish's brother Phineas co-wrote the song, making it a brother-sister duo, which is very rare in modern music. The beat of the song is kind of like been described as electropop. And in the lyrics, Eilish makes fun of people who try to brag that they are a bad guy. And obviously the song is very popular and won several awards, including Song of the Year and last Grammys. And to top that off, it dethroned Old Town Road from its infamous like 19-week venture at the number one spot. And so that song dethroned it.
"Bad Guy" by Billie Eilish. What do you got? You have a picture? What do you got here?
Yeah, it's a visual. This is her at the Grammys last year.
And Bodhi, if I'm not mistaken, isn't Billie Eilish from Los Angeles?
I think she is.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she is. And actually, I think she still lives at home because she's what, 19, maybe 19, 20 at the most?
Yeah. It's crazy.
Really young. Wow. So "Bad Guy" from Billie Eilish. I knew that as soon as he started playing that. That was awesome. Thank you so much, Bodhi. Hey, listen, Luca's Laudable Laughs, we haven't been announcing it this week, but it's been up all week. We want to remind everybody that his focus this week is to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. Luca wants you to draw a four-leaf clover, and each of the clovers, he wants you to write a reason why you are lucky, and he's going to select some of those to share tomorrow. Now, for Women's History Month, what a coincidence that you did Billie Eilish when we are going to cover another famous woman with the first name Billie. Now, let me put her picture up. And this is Billie Holiday. Let's see. Are you seeing? Can you see Billie Holiday there, guys?
Yep, I can.
Yes.
Okay, so this is Billie Holiday. Hannah, tell everybody about Billie Holiday and why we would be celebrating her for Women's History Month.
Billie Holiday was an American jazz singer and songwriter. Holiday was a very important influence on jazz and pop singing. It was said that the way she sang was similar to the way jazz musicians played their instruments.
Excellent. And actually, let's a little listen to, if I can do this. You guys know I get nervous with my technology, but let's see my music. And here's a little sample of Billie Holiday singing.
With you the first time I looked into them eyes, and you have a certain little cute way of flirting with them eyes.
All right, and that's a sample of Billie Holiday, the two Billies this morning on the morning announcements. You had your Billie Eilish, now you've got your Billie Holiday. We salute her for Women's History Month. And now for the words of wisdom.
Let's talk about principles for a minute. Not principles like Mr. Martinez, but the type of principles that are the rules for living. Beliefs that help us know what we ought to do or not do.
Principles, boys and girls, help us in life. Whether our principles are based on our religious beliefs or on the lessons we have been taught by our parents and caregivers or the morals we learn from books and stories.
When you know what your rules are for living, it is much easier to know, to make the right choice.
Today, take the time to make a list of the principles you believe in, your own special rules for how you want to be the best person you can be. Then think about how those principles help you make better choices.
With something to think about, this is Mr. Martinez.
And Bodhi.
And Hannah.
Make it a great day.
Or not.
The choice is yours. Hannah, you were a great special guest today. Do you have any shout outs for anybody before we sign off?
Yeah. Shout out to my family, my classroom 16, and my teacher, Ms. Shaheen, and you, Mr. Martinez.
Thank you, Hannah. Boys and girls, have a great day of school tomorrow. We'll see you. Luca's here tomorrow. Remember, go to Luca's Laudable Apps on the website. Put in your four-leaf clover and what you are looking for and what you are lucky for, and you might be highlighted tomorrow. Have a great day, guys. See you tomorrow.
See you. Bye.
See you. Bye.